have a unique perspective, Alex, when you're in space and you can see just how fragile the environment is, how thin our atmosphere looks, and how parts of the Earth are covered with pollution almost all the time. So it really, I think people that have had the privilege of having the experience of looking out at the Earth from space want to do more when they get back to help it.
And you've talked about all the scientific research that's done up there on the ISS. To what degree are you able to take what you learned there and implement it down here?
So we, on the space station, for the year I was up there, did about 400 different scientific experiments. Some of them were focused on improving life on Earth, things like basic research in biology, chemistry, physics, in combustion efficiency, pharmaceuticals. There have been drugs that have been made from space-based research. And then also the other thing is it's about exploration. It's about, you know, how we leave low Earth orbit and go to Mars someday. And that's why my colleague Misha and I, a Russian cosmonaut, were there for an entire year.
I want to read a few lines from your book on another takeaway from your time in space, in which you wrote, "Sir, I've learned that this moment in American spaceflight is a crossroads where we can either renew our commitment to push further out, to build on our successes, to keep doing harder and harder things, or else to lower our sights and compromise our goals." What direction would you say we are heading in today?
You know, it's hard to say. When you change administrations, presidential administrations, you also often get a change in direction. And I think right now NASA doesn't have a whole lot of guidance, but hopefully we will soon. And I hope that the guidance we do get from the government is to continue on the path we're on, and that is to, you know, allow companies like SpaceX and Boeing and other companies to be the, you know, how we get to and back from low Earth orbit, and then allow NASA to keep building a new rocket, SLS, and a Orion capsule to launch astronauts to Mars someday.
You know, it's interesting because I know that the effects of space were chronicled on you as well as your twin brother, Mark, while he was obviously here on Earth. But there was something that you wrote about how you looked at fruit when it would be delivered, fresh fruit, a very precious commodity there on the International Space Station. And you'd see, for reasons that remain unexplained, why it would deteriorate or it would go bad quickly. And you're thinking, oh my goodness, is this happening to me in my body? Is there anything that would indicate that it was tougher for you up in space, physiologically speaking, than for your brother here on Earth?
Well, there are a lot of negative effects to being in space for long periods of time. We lose bone mass, muscle mass. There's effects on our vision, the structures of our eyes. And then, of course, the radiation. There's a lot of radiation in space, and, you know, I got a lot more than my brother did. And that's the reason we were doing this twin study. In some cases, to understand the difference on me being in space and the harsh environment versus him being on Earth and, you know, relatively, you know, easy life in Tucson, Arizona.
Well, you have had an enviable career, particularly from this person who dreams of going in space one of these days. But it's wonderful to speak with you. The book is Endurance, A Year in Space, A Lifetime of Discovery. Scott Kelly, thank you so much.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.